Bank, one of the groups working overtime right now, trying to help those in need after the weekend's historic flooding.
Ajay live in Mapunapuna with more on how you can help the Hawaii Food Bank.
Just to let you know, yeah, you'll see signs like this at malls all across the state, actually, this Saturday. That's because it's the 29th annual food drive for the Food Bank of Hawaii, Hawaii Food Bank. Now, here, top two list as far as things to get if you wanted to really do a great job. Canned protein, so things like tuna, and then also canned meals like chili or spaghetti. We wanted to find out more from one of those who's sort of on the front line. Pat Lee, she is with Kalihi Union Church. Yeah. That's a church that's been in existence for more than 100 years. Pat, if you don't mind, tell me some of the people who you are helping on a daily basis.
There are many families who are either working poor, where like one family, the husband got hurt, and so it's only the wife working. Another one who's a single mom with four boys, she can pay her rent, but she can't afford food. So it's not only food that I bring boxes actually to the families like that. And then in addition, you know, toilet paper and other necessities, soap, toothpaste, whatever we can find here. Because there is a miscellaneous bunch of things here that is really helpful.
And do you come on a daily basis, weekly basis? How often do you make it down to the Hawaii Food Bank?
My group actually comes every day only because we do about 160 to 175 bags of food on a weekly basis. We service the high schools, the intermediate, the elementary schools. There's a big thing coming up at Farrington High School where they're having a get together with all the kids, including dinner and games and all these things. That's going to be on the Farrington campus. We do Christmas parade. We do harvest, which is a Halloween alternative. We do Easter sunrise sun, S-O-N rise service.
That's important to know that it is S-O-N. Pat, thank you very much. And the food bank, they could not exist without those kind of community organizations. Again, it's going to be happening on Saturday. Later on this morning, we will post all the information you need to know on our website at KHON2.com. All right, on the traffic front on this Wednesday, we head back in the wake of today's studio. We check in with Chris Letronic.